Hey, welcome back to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting. Today we're going to be doing something pretty cool. We're diving into the Bong69 controller. This controller was designed by none other than Bob Kojima. Now, if you've been around this hobby for a while, you may have heard of the board, you may not have heard of the board, but if you're watching this, you've heard of it now. It's an 8-port LED controller that's built around the ESP32. There's been several versions of it, each one improving on the last one. So today, I'm gonna show you the top three versions that I like. Version 2, version 3, and version 4. With all three versions here, I'm going to show you how it's evolved over time. Let's get right into the video. Here we go. I've always been a fan of the Bong69 boards. They were the first ones that I owned. And now Bob has sent me over a couple more to test out, to review, and see if I like them. Thanks so much, I really appreciate it. So this is version 4. And you can tell right away that it's refined, it's production ready. Let's get into some of the details about it. Let's look inside the packaging when they arrive and what it looks like. All right, so once we take it out of the box, it's gonna come in this packaging here. Packed really well, really nice. And there it is. Version 4 of the Bong69 controller. Clean blue PCB, bright green terminal blocks, and that Ethernet front and center. On the back, we got some labeling here. Tells you what your inputs are. Gives you your output, your suggested gauge of wiring to use, and what your fuses are set at. Scan that QR code, brings you up to a website and helps you set it up in WLED. Has all your GPIOs listed, real nice on the back there. So let's talk about what's new here. The board now includes a dedicated Ethernet jack, so you can hardwire your connection if you don't want to rely on the Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi is great. I run everything hardwired. My first year, I ran everything Wi-Fi. They both work really well. The difference is when you're programming X lights, if you're at a high frame rate, I do everything at 40 frames per second. I see that the Wi-Fi tends to lag a little bit. So when you go hardwired, you don't have that lagging. If you're doing simple things, some things I run wireless, some things I run hardwired. You're doing simple things, wireless is okay as well. But you have the options, that's a plus. It's got 8 output ports, each labeled with data and power terminals, D1 through D8. It's hard to mess this up. It's written right on the board. You take, what are those connectors? Phoenix connectors. I always forget them. I forget they're called Phoenix connectors. Right on the board, it's labeled clearly of how your Phoenix connector should be wired. It's got 8 ports, these 8 right here. Each labeled with data and power terminals, D1 through 8. So you can see down here, LED1, GPIO1, there's your negative, your data, your positive, so your negative data and positive. LED2, GPIO2, and so forth, all the way down. The power range, written clearly on the edge down here, 12 to 48 volts. Here's your positive terminal. Here's your negative terminal. Makes it super flexible. For different applications, I'm gonna use mine with my Govies as a 36 volts. You'll notice the surface mount 1808 fuses. And this is important, they're not resettable. You know, so if one blows, it needs to be replaced. And you can see a much cleaner power filtering section right here. The capacitors and layout have been refined compared to the older versions. Just a much cleaner board. The power range is from 12 volts to 48 volts. Gives you a huge spectrum to work with. So I've got all three versions laid out now. Let's take a look and compare and contrast the differences from earlier versions compared to the one that we just received now. So version two here, cleaned up the board layout and made things look a little bit more stable than version one. I don't have a picture of version one. Made it more stable, better GPIO labeling. Nothing on the back of this one because it's all in the front. Looks like he included everything on the front though. So there's your GPIO outputs. It's regulated for 5 volt, 12 volt, and 24 volt. Regular fuses in it there. Terminal block for your power. Still nice and thin, nothing really poking up. USB-C. So this is version two. Let's look at version three. So version three, still silk screen on the front, looks really good. You see all your GPIOs on there. You see your GPIO labels down here as well. Got your negative on the left, that in the middle, positive on the right. Same thing, terminal block. Labels right here, 5 volt, 12 volt, or 24 volt. That was the maximum that you could do on these boards. Same USB-C, programming, flashing. Dedicated Ethernet, nothing on the back, still nice and thin. So there's version 3.1. And we just look at the difference of version four here. I really like on the back that he put all the information. You can also put a QR code you can scan. Pretty cool idea, pretty cool design. It's got terminals on here. So here, everything comes together. Version three, Bob introduced the flat ribbon style fuses and improved the power handling. This version really started to look like a mature design. Still had the Ethernet. These are self-resetting fuses, so when one heats up too much, it'll pop on the inside. Once it cools down, it resets itself. So I thought that was a really cool feature. This is what I upgraded all my 5 volts to, was this board here. And then here we are, version 4. Now you can see on this one, it only handles between 12 volt and 48 volts. So we dropped the 5 volt support for version 4 here. So if you're still running 5 volts, I'd come back to version 3. This is what I'm running everything on. This is probably my favorite one here. This one's gonna run my little bit higher end, higher capacity. It's good stuff. So let's power it up real quick and take a look at when it's all lit up here. You'll see the ESP32 boot up. Status lights, got your power LED up here, which is green. You got status LEDs on all your outputs. Gives you an okay if it's blue, and if it's popped, that light will go out. Then from here, you can log into WLED, and because it's Wi-Fi, it's gonna grab an IP automatically. This is great. I like these boards because I can control my Govies or I can control my Jellyfish with these. I don't like the Govee app. I think it's clunky. I am not able to sync the Govees up with X lights through their app. I put this controller in to replace the app and replace their controller. So now I have complete full control of all my Govee lights. And they run at 36 volts. And there you have it. A full look through the evolution of the Bong69 controller, all the way from version 2 to version 4 that we have now. And a huge shout out to Bob Kojima for designing this and supporting our LED community. It's awesome to see this kind of quality come from a one-man project. If you want to pick up one of these, I've got the links down below. We can get them at a couple places. There's also links down below that'll help you set them up. Pretty simple and easy. And I've also got a video that shows you how to set it all up in WLED. So please make sure you hit that like and hit that subscribe button where I make a video showing you how to set it all the way up in WLED from beginning to end, and I get it to talk to X lights. It's a pretty good video, you'll like it. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one. It's good stuff. I like it, it's a great board. I'm gonna use it. I'm using it on everything. I'm gonna use it on stuff I don't even need it for. Nah, I'll probably just use it on my Govies. I like it. Good stuff. Cool design.